Thank you. Tonight and supporting the arts. I'd like to thank our CEO of Public Lender for making this possible, our board members, and especially our board members who are on the committee, Marie Berman, Lane Brookfield, Dennis Brookfield, Gary Blackfield, and Linda McNavenport, she's our committee member on the board of the committee, and Phyllis Foreman, who just joined the committee recently. I'd like to say a few words about the work of the committee. I'd like to ask Dennis to say a few words about the work of the committee that we do here for the Gallery of Mary Berman.
I'm honest to have exhibits. I've had different people on board, maybe those people you have, are amazed at what could be in the way work from the world. Many of the works are in other projects, when they appear here, it's amazing to them to see what they're working on. The reason for that, of course, is the work of the I want to tell you how you do it. Before I do that, I want to say that there is one member of the committee, and that is you. Ella is the real work of the committee. She takes down the old shows, new shows, she walks around a bunch of little ones. Thank you. What we do with the show, when it comes, we take all the pieces and put them on the floor by the wall, line them up, and we then choose what we think is going to be the middle one, and we work from the middle. Choose that one, and then this process goes like this one and put it there, and that one and put it there, and that one and put it all the way up the bar in, and move it all around until we keep it. And we put it up on the wall, and then we do it all again. We move it here, we move it there, and that's the way we do it until we are done. The problem that we have, well, it's strange, we've got two artists, one with two different things, and one is probably the truth. So, the things we have to be sure that we don't for a thing so that's what we did, and the wall to my left looks gorgeous now after a three or four years of that wall. And this is the final video with Fred. Then we got to the other wall as another problem. We came on the ground, we moved on the floor, we put on the floor, we moved on the floor, nothing to see, until we decided that slanting down the table and nothing more to do. And so,
thank you, Dennis. And I have to say that when the artist in the film Black Gator, he was very grateful for the way he installed in the zigzag in office your talent and appreciated it. I'd like to invite Milcom first to say a few words. He's here with us. Milcom, he's getting out. Thank you very much for being a part of our exhibit. You've been waiting for a long time, and we are very honored to have you.
I was listening to that pomp and opera on the Saturday afternoon. He was given the marriage of Figaro. And Figaro said, if you want to dance, I'll play the tune. Because his intended wife is liked by the count, and he wants the right to the first night. And Figaro said, well, if you want to dance, I'll play the tune.
Okay. Well, can you understand me?
Yeah.
Okay. Because I was an abstract director for a while, and I 25 years ago, this one was working on something else on this one. These forms and these forms started to paint tone computer, and so I worked on it and brought them out. It looks like they're attacking each other. There's one on the end, you can see it. It's called Archer. Okay. I decided I needed a background for him, so I just laid it on top of the background. He was in the museum show.
Thank you so much. We're very honored to have you here at the JCC. Thank you so much. Thank you for being patient. And we're enjoying the art here. It's also the pieces are for sale if anyone is interested, of course.
Oh, really beautiful what they did.
All the committees work, we have to thank them.
Very beautiful work.
Thank you, it's our pleasure. I'd like to also welcome our second artist, Lou Russo. Lou is a man of many talents. He's originally from Brooklyn. He's a musician. His wife is here today. Lou, would you like to say a few words?
Well, can I ask you I was saying to myself this morning, you know, usually you don't get the chance to talk about your artwork. So they show your artwork in. So I'm gonna take the opportunity to tell you what's going on over here. And I know I'm getting going far away. So over here is that's my self-portrait that I did with Arco. And of course I had to have my guitar in my self-portrait. My guitar's name is Roletta. And she was born in 1955. And she loves to sing. And this I did when Elvis passed away. You know, my generation loved Elvis. And you know, what I did was I left his mouth out of the rotation, and I just put a woman who kept kissing Elvis' body. This was inspired by Gail Middleton, a wonderful lady from the Staten Island Creative Community who passed away this morning. Every morning she would put up a photograph of a sunrise, and to remind us all that every day begins a new day. And she inspired me to do this painting. And I sent it to her. I said, Gail, I love your photograph. And she had, what I didn't know is that she had a bad heart. And the reason she was going to the ocean every day to take a photograph and put on for a couple of years is that she knew she had a bad heart. This one, you know, when I saw the video on the Sullivan Show, of course, that's when I took out my book. I told my dad to give me an electric. And he took me down to Park Slope. And he bargained with the salesman all day long. And he got the tax taken. I did that with this character usually for John Cadell's film, Storm Coffee Night. So it's sort of the mock time evolved into what became the Demon Kingdom. That I teach at CSI if he comes in and we need to do something. So this leader are two deceased people, and I call that heavenly leader. And I took the prophets that were in their lives, in their, you know, Krishna and Buddha and Jiva. And I included their guitars, because why would they go to heaven without their guitars? That wouldn't be heaven. This painting I did was my home in downtown Brooklyn, 100 East 5th Avenue. And we moved from downtown Brooklyn, which is a bad neighborhood, to Fast Street, which is a nice neighborhood. But I had the recollection of my bicycle growing up in a child. And I'm over here on this little scooter, and these children playing the soldier game and the soldier game. We would write on the sidewalk with the boxes, and we would back auto capture. And my sister was over here on the fire escape. And my sister, as a child, put her head into the bars of the fire escape and couldn't get her hat. So my father just kind of ran over and then shot him with venom and put him on the car. And he carried her for the pictures of the house. And those bars stay that way forever. Spike Lee brought our house. Spike Lee headquarters became 100 East 5th Avenue up as well. This movie, He's Got a Habit, they're sitting in the kitchen and I'm saying, I know that kitchen. And then what worked out dead at 100 East 5th Avenue. Okay, so that's a good block. Because you carved into a block of wood, you carved into the dead of the stage. Then you put tape on it and pop it over to the print. I had never done that before. And when I was at that age, I thought, this is going to be done wrong. But I wrote the memoir first, but I didn't know the name. But he has a little, his model is back there, you know, like that was my idea for him. But this is Hillary Clinton, who I was sort of forecasting the first morning president of the United States. And I made a postage stamp for her, and I made the seal, my glass seal. These were all the things. She was sort of like a wonder woman because she was like the first woman that could be the president of the United States. But we still don't have her book. Frank Zappa's last words were the poet's wife. His wife left him. The doctors told him he was going to die of cancer. And then he found out he was going to die. So he's a very different person. And so I have his head on plate here, his true of the wife. And I don't know if his wife is true. But this is what he said. This painting is the 1986 Mets. And my wife, Terry, and I are here in the corner. We were at the game 6 for painting Mickey Wilson. Where a guy came down on the field with a parachute. He landed one vital bar, has been sitting right over here about first day. And I have Davy Johnson from the Alpina. I have Jesse Orosco's last pitch of the game, and Mickey Wilson's famous ground ball to Bill Buckner. And I drew this from memory here because I watched so many games that I knew the people. I remember the general look of each player. When I came out of art school, my first job was at an agency, and they asked me to be a co-director for Business Week Magazine. And I had to get my pen and get on the subway and visit each one of these buildings and draw the building with my computer. Remember what was this actually. They don't make them anymore. They have new pencils like the system. But I have all kinds of, I have my wife Carol's here with me, and my brother's kids, and I have a car man jumping off the bridge. And I have all kinds of, I have three students up here. This was my painting of my beloved, Brooklyn Dodgers. And when I watched the Brooklyn Dodgers, they were on a black and white future skate, and they were fine. My dad took me as a kid, and there they are, in color. And I say, I'm going to do a painting, and I'm going to make them bigger than life. I'm going to make my colors bigger than life. And that's what I did. And I called, we went to a commemoration ceremony in Everett Field, and the head of the Brooklyn Dodgers Hall of Fame was there. And I told my little piece of them, he was, oh, okay, well, you send it to me if you have to come up. He's probably going to. But anyway, I did the painting, and then I never sent it to him. Honestly, it was a year later. And we came home from work, the uncle said, Boo, I got the painting. I love the painting. We're putting it up in the Brooklyn Dodgers Hall of Fame. So, my family still lives in Brooklyn. We're talking about the Hall of Fame in the Brooklyn City. And my nephews have their teachers for the class continuum. This is up to the end of the pre-release of Queen and Jackie Robinson's book. I mean, and I was the youngest kid that grew up in that house. We copy everything. All those cousins, all the cousins of mine, all avid Brooklyn Dodgers. It was like, that little kid, he did a painting that's in the Brooklyn Dodgers that painting. That little kid was just pushing around. Okay, so this was from Reader's Digest. They asked me to illustrate the Roosevelt family, this book from the Roosevelt. And I drew those faces from them. I did the painting from memory, and then I said, is this okay? And they said, oh, you captured it. That's it. You don't have to do research. This was, I think, a Reader's Digest also. It's a series of these watercolor illustrations. That's the little tin watercolor thing that you have with the colors, and you move the water on your brush to make your colors brighter and darker. This was like a collection of people that I've known. And the whole series of black and white photos, of watercolor photos. This was a college assignment to illustrate Thanksgiving on living heritage, and I had the idea to do turkey that's about to get head cut off in the middle. And Gail Middleton, she hired me to do this illustration of the Staten Island Theater community, and based on what she saw from that year, And as I said, Gail, again, was my muse to inspire me. Fordham University saw the Business Week one, and they wanted me to do this one for Fordham University. So now you get some different painting, and now you can do it in color, or you can change the angle of it. This was my Israel, this process of the war in Israel. This is called War's Help. It's like, how does a musician handle war, which is great. There's no justifying war one way or the other. How do you handle it? You can just put a screen at the sky and play your music or draw your picture. This was a Bob Dylan show we had at UCB Cafe, and I did this poster for Bob. And all my life, my heroes were Pee Wee Reese and Jackie Robinson, because he was the white guy from Kentucky, and he came up in a racist family. And he threw his arm around Jackie Robinson. And he slaughtered his passing the ball to Jackie. He's saying, we can go forward. We can have players of all colors. And to me, as a child, that was his farm. And now when I look back and I said, yeah, but that's what he wants. But back then, it was a big deal. My heroes on TV were Davy Crockett and Roy Rogers. And Davy Crockett was the king of the Wild Frontier. Roy Rogers was the king of the Wild West, king of the Cowboys. The name Roy means king. They gave him that name. His real name was Leonard Earl. Leonard Earl. Imagine Leonard Earl being a Cowboy. No. And of course, Howdy Doody was my childhood show. And I said, I want to do a painting of Howdy Doody and Buffalo Bob, but I made Howdy Doody a puppeteer, and I made Buffalo Bob a puppeteer. So that's my life so far.
Thank you all. Thank you everyone for participating, and thank you most of the organizations playing for us. No, we have someone who would like to talk to. I don't know how we have time. I don't know if we can first, but we have to. Okay, well, enjoy the reception, everyone.
Thank you.
And so when you do it, you're cutting out what you're doing. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yes, the power. Thank you.
A couple of months ago, I woke up to a dead the day of that philology. He says that what I have looks so. Yeah, then, no, what I have is a cubicle. What is it? What do you call that? Cubicle. Right. So I have to go get a projector in my elbow. And then I'll be able to play. Just think of it again. You can't be doing stupid things. But anyway, you probably just told you I don't have to do stupid things. This one I loved when I heard this movie. This was Fred Astaire singing the ginger art.
Thank you. Oh,